Oh, I'm sorry.
Shall we take the coffin to the coffin car for you?
No. Could I see him? I know it's a bit,
it's the last chance I'll get.
Of course, if that's what you want, then I don't see why not.
Very, very good idea, yeah. The way we do it is like the family sees the face and it provides with closure and that, yeah.
Well, we could all learn so much from Hinduism.
Come on.
Would you mind?
Oh, no, of course. Where are you off to?
Wedding rehearsal.
Oh.
No, not mine.
Oh.
No, I'm not getting married. It's an old friend's. I'm not. Are you? Did you meet anybody on your travels?
No. No, nobody. No. I'm alone. Single, not lonely.
You've never done this before, have you?
Never done what?
Tied a tie?
No. I'm so sorry.
Hi. Nat. How are you?
Fine.
That's good. I was hoping I'd run into you, actually. I found a few things on your desk that I thought you might like to have, so...
Thanks.
We're all missing, you know. Coming back to work might do you good, actually.
Yeah. I'll think about it.
Hey, do you have a girlfriend?
When did you decide?
You're very strangely proportioned, Thomas. I mean, physically.
Yeah, when did you decide to start making my life a misery?
I asked you a question, Thomas. Girlfriend?
Why? You offering?
No, I'm not.
Despite the best efforts of the staff, Valerie Brayford remains inconsolable. She now faces a long, anxious wait till the team manage to locate her father's body.
Boy, a nice guy.
I'm sorry, I don't... It's been such a weird day. I mean, I certainly never thought this would happen.
Me neither.